with Aditi, and we also have Rhythm with us now, who has someone from the Bar Council. Remember, he is the person who had filed that complaints against Jitender Singh Tomar. Rhythm, if you can hear me, what's really the Bar Council stand on this? Were they in the know? Okay, I'm given to understand that Rhythm has already spoken to this person from the Bar Council. Let's play out his reaction.
Kejriwal government, their law minister Tomar has been arrested today. We speak to the chief of the Bar Council, the man on whose complaint the entire thing has happened, Mr. KK Manan. Sir, firstly, Tomar has been arrested. What is the procedure? What was the complaint you had filed in the High Court on the basis of which this entire action has happened?
No, we have not filed any complaint before the Honorable High Court. In fact, we sent a complaint to the DCP Hauz Khaz, South Delhi, for preliminary inquiry, just for our own satisfaction. And before that, we have already internal inquiry got conducted, in which his BSc degree was found forged. But by taking just precautions, we sent this complaint for preliminary inquiry, and they were to report to the Delhi Bar Council on or before 28th May 2015, but they did not. On 27th of May, our Bar Council meeting was there. So next date was given, I think 7th July, and he was given last and final opportunity to produce the original documents as well as file his reply, though he did not for the last about so many dates. Neither he was filing the reply nor he was producing the original documents on the basis he got the license from the council.
So then what do we make out of the arrest today? Is it legal? A lot of legal luminaries say this arrest is illegal because there is a sub judice matter in the court.
I can't comment upon, but law is very clear. How it is sub judice before the court? If the degree, it is a cognizable offence. Who told and who is this legal luminaries who says that this arrest is illegal? But if the offence is cognizable, and yes, if it would have been only 420 IPC, there is a judgment of Arnesh Kumar that the police could have deferred his arrest. But they have added section 467, in which the sentence is up to life and 10 years. So they could have arrested him. That was not a problem. But we have just sent a complaint for preliminary inquiry. But you know the law. And law is very clear. Anybody, even person going on the road, he can make a complaint thereafter. If he becomes the complainant, thereafter it is up to the investigating agency how to investigate the matter. Even the court can't direct the investigating agency how to investigate the matter. It is their prerogative, and prerogative is very simple. And it was a case of forgery, cheating, etc. So if they have taken cognizance of a cognizable offence, it is not an illegal arrest. Whatever other people are saying, I can't comment upon their opinion.
Mr. Manan, what about the fake degrees? We have heard you've gone into all the documents. What are the degrees really saying is the bottom line here?
You see that he has filed the degrees of BSc, certificates, degree, then BSc, thereafter I think he has filed the LLB. So the documentation attestation by the notary itself is there is a discrepancy. Contradictions are there, but we could have overlooked it because notarized documents can be notarized at any time, day, month, year. That's not a problem. Problem was that the degree on the basis of the mark sheets.
Right.
That was forced, which that we have got it done from the university itself. Now the investigating agency must have done it before the arrest. The investigating agency must have taken the opinion of the prosecution before his arrest. They are not the kids. They are not playing, a small game. And it's just a case of under the eyes of law, which is totally tenable in the eyes of law. That's not a problem.
And my last question to you, Mr. Manan, what is the kind of action you would want against Mr. Tomar? How do you look at it legally? Because you've been a very senior criminal lawyer. What, in your opinion, should the action be against him?
It is not a new case with the Bar Council. Delhi Bar Council also found such type of people earlier also, and we cancelled the license and recommended the case for registration, and the persons have been arrested and cases are going on in the courts. It's not a new case for us. And number of times the people have done it, and the same fate he will face.
Arrest.
You told us that
he has been
already arrested, and right. If it is arrested, then he will be produced before the court of law, court, within 24 hours.
And then, sir, what is the future course of action once it's produced in the Saket court, so as to say?
Police may take his police remand to take him to the university, the colleges where he studied, and whatever the documentation they have to collect on his instance. The investigating agency may ask for police remand. If they don't require for police remand, they can send him in judicial custody. And the defense will work, and their own strategies, I can't comment upon them.
All right, it's a huge jolt to the Kejriwal government. Their law minister is arrested. We really have to see what the future course of action today will be. But for now, Mr. Manan clarifying one thing, the degrees are forged.